Clean them up there, the street, clean them up there.
Hello? 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 Work time! Hard! Low, hard! Pull!
One, two!
Low, hard!
One, two!
Hey! It's about the easiest group of them there is. Go, head, hold!
Get the chief! My name's Lord! Drive off your sword now!
Right, hold! All right! Hold!
I think all of our people are well trained in the procedures and what has to be done, and are alert to the signs when you've got a heat injury coming. But the main problem it forces upon us is that we've got to do our training around the hot part of the day when we're likely to injure people.
One, two, three, four, seven, eight, down.
One, two,
three, four, we are Delta. Mighty, mighty Delta.
In fact, most of these guys are very enthusiastic, and they want to complete their road march. They want to do well in the PT test, and they don't always know their limitations, especially if they come from a northern climate where it's a lot cooler and they haven't been exposed to it.
Go, go!
Go, go!
Go, go!
Go, go!
Looks, gotta have looks, right? Figure, poise, enthusiasm, smile, and dancing ability, okay? These are the different areas that we'll be judging in. And the most important thing, all right, thanks.
The employees were ushered into the meat locker, which is in the back of the restaurant, after a robbery, and then executed individually. We believe that a small caliber weapon was used. Five of the employees were dead when we arrived. The sixth was taken to University Hospital. She has since expired. We believe we have five male victims and one female victim.
called and he said, Mom, the house is on fire. I said, you're kidding. And he said, no, I'm not. Listen. And he put the phone out and I could hear the sirens. I believed him. I hung up the phone and came on.
Everybody got out okay?
We're just fine. Thank God.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is probably the most horrendous crime that's been committed in the Oklahoma City area since I've been a police officer. And I talked to some officers that had 25 and 30 years last night, and it's the worst they've ever seen. And so it was a shock to walk in that cooler and see those five victims. And the Oklahoma City Police Service, of course, extends the sympathies to families, and we will leave no stone unturned to apprehend these killers.
We are appealing, of course, to any persons who are in the restaurant or in the area who may have seen or heard anything that might be of help to us. We would ask that they come forward, contact our homicide unit.
The tragedy of the deaths last night of six of our employees leaves all of us at Sirloin Stockade with a deep sense of loss and sadness. Sirloin Stockade offers a $25,000 reward to anyone who gives information leading to the arrest and conviction of the person or persons responsible for the deaths of these six employees.
This is probably the most horrendous crime that's been committed in the Oklahoma City area since I've been a police officer. And I talked to some officers that had 25 and 30 years last night, and it's the worst they've ever seen. And so it was a shock to walk in that cooler and see those five victims. And the Oklahoma City Police Service, of course, extends its sympathies to families, and we will leave no stone unturned to apprehend these killers.
The investigation has led us now to theorize specifically that there are three individuals involved. We further theorize at this point that two of the three were shooters, that the third individual was probably serving only as an involved person in the robbery. Further advise you at this time that the evidence gathered at the crime scene appears to be excellent for the purposes of use as evidence in future court trials. That evidence of various types is currently being examined by the lab technicians here and with the Oklahoma State Bureau of Investigation.
Because many defendants and their lawyers requested to see the videotape once we played on stolen property crime.
It's a downturn in that type of crime in Oklahoma County.
As a result of an industry or something like that or something.
So there has to, whatever you feel about the death penalty, seems to be in that particular situation, there has to be a difference between the penalty if you commit an armed robbery and don't kill the people, and if you commit an armed robbery and do kill them.
How many did you say are jailed now?
How many?
Also use this tape to train other officers in the sting operation and in the handling of evidence. And so I think we learned a great deal from this. And I think it also helped eliminate some of the criminal element from Streetsville at the same time. And I think it served warning on some burglars that
a number of pleas than they might otherwise get, because many defendants and their lawyers requested to see the videotape once we played.
See who's actually in operation here.
Do you foresee any?
But again, look at the fact that he has lived in several residences in District 46, went down to OU and came back and did register and comply with the law and did move into the house and did become a bona fide, as Mr. Laird said, resident of Oklahoma County, District 46 of the State Senate. Thank you.
He was living at Norman, by his own statement. He had to live there to hold the job he held. When he was president and lobbyist, paid lobbyist for common cause, He lived down there and worked in Oklahoma City. His lobbyist application shows that he worked in Oklahoma City, but he lived down there. Yet he would have us believe that when he's working and going to school at Norman, he was actually living in Oklahoma City.
The Oklahoma City Police Service has prepared an open letter to a mystery witness. We do not yet know your name, but we will. You are the key to the solution of the worst murder in our city's history. We know that you have seen or heard something and that you want to tell us the truth. If you were present when six died and did not pull a trigger, you are not a killer. If you have been told about the crime, you have nothing to fear from us. But you are in danger. These men have killed at least six times, coldly and without feeling. They will not hesitate to kill again, because they must remain free and undetected. The penalty they face is monumental. If you know them and what they did, you will almost certainly be their next victim, if only to ensure your silence. I stand ready to meet with you at the time and place of your choosing. In addition to the rightness of your act in coming forward, you will receive $50,000 reward upon the arrest and conviction of the true killers. Your safety will be assured. I await your call at 231-2333.
Think anyone would do that at all except an ABC agent. Certainly a Tulsa policeman wouldn't do it, a sheriff's officer wouldn't do it, the ABC would.
What would they hope to gain from that, do you think, Joe?
Just aggravation. They're an aggravating source.
Well, I think that's a ridiculous allegation, and I think it's an allegation to criticize the board for doing their job proper. The liquor, when it is confiscated from a club, is inventoried and turned over to the local sheriff. From there, our ABC agents never touch the liquor again.
I've been real scared lately. We don't go out to eat at night like we used to.
I wouldn't work in 7-Eleven or none of these places stay late than that. There's too many nuts running loose.
The frightening thing about this to me is my daughter worked there for 2.5 years, and it could have just as easily happened at that time when she was employed there.
Well, I'm not scared, but I'm concerned the fact that something like this would happen in this neighborhood.
It's real, you know, down in the dumps there for a while, because we eat over here once in a while. And it's just sickening that there's people losing the world to do this sort of thing.
Oh, no, I'm not scared. What's the use to be scared? If they're going to get you, they're going to get you.
I'll admit I have been kind of scared about it, and I imagine anybody is. It just makes me sick. I'll never eat there. I doubt that very many people will.
We held interviews all last week in three major races, Attorney General, Governor, and U.S. Senate. And one of the things that helped convince us about Larry Derryberry was also very convincing about Gene Stipe and was not convincing about Governor Bourne. And that is the issue that has been a high priority around here for some time, and that's negotiations. And many of us know that to have a negotiations law as soon as we need it, we may have to depend on the federal level to attain it. And not only the right to negotiate, that's not always the problem, especially in Oklahoma, but how do you settle differences that cannot be settled at the table?
Test solution and the mercury have reacted to form what we're going to call wine. Okay? Now what happened in that reaction was that the reactive acids. Now I have to advise some of you that this won't work some of the time. Okay? Sometimes it will and sometimes it won't. So here it goes. And it worked this time. Okay, this right. Okay, this right here is taking. Okay, now I'll tell you this right now. Okay, I think I'll do because there's still a little bit more left.
We would ask at this time that you entertain a motion to vote on, number one, to dismantle the present facilities on the grounds that they are a hazard and represent a liability. Number two, that they prohibit the construction of permanent camping facilities at the fairgrounds until such time that the private sector can no longer meet the demand.
If there is really a need for some of the exhibitors to be there, then I think this council is going to have to develop some very refined and strict guidelines so that, in fact, it is going to be used only for people that have some very important business to attend to right there, and or that it can be used as an overflow facility.
Thank you.
It's hard for me to believe that a group of citizens would believe a story that he only sells ice and gives away whiskey. We're very disappointed in that ruling, and it's hard for us to believe that the people in the state of Oklahoma would believe such a thing also. It's something like a man going in and buying a hamburger and saying they only sell the bun, giving away the meat. And around the law. We think it's just another way to get around the law and try to get us out of raiding clubs.
Is this going to affect your raiding of clubs in all areas of Oklahoma?
It will not. The Oklahoma.